a cell signal. A cell signal is about a fundamental cable system of communication that plants cells use to regulate cellular activities. Transduction refers to the steps and processes that the cell goes through to translate all the signals into a language that the cell understands for response to the place. Now, cells have different ways to receive signals from external sources. Now, one of these is the cell junction. Now, cell junction refers to proteins that surround the cytoplasm of the cell, and they are responsible for receiving signals from external sources or some cells, cell itself. Cells can only communicate with one another. And then, a cell like this here cannot communicate with this one because it has no protrusions, and then communication cannot take place. Now, cell signaling this is another type of signaling where cells are not close to each other. pass through the plasma membrane, so we go there to the targets. G protein coupled receptors require a G protein to function. This is a diagram of the G protein. It has several helix sizes, and these sizes are always constant. They are always constant, and then ABC signals, and then work with the help of GTP to transport signals from. From receptors to the transduction stage. This is another diagram of it. This diagram just explains how the G protein receptors work. Now here you can see that the G protein coupled receptor is just active by that. And the G protein is bound into a G, which is some just a type of energy in the body. Well, at this stage it's an inactive form. So here, when a signal is received by the receptor, the G protein, the GDP, calls to another GDP, which converts the GDP to a GTP, and then it binds the active amount to the receptor right here, just to receive a signal from the motor organ to the enzyme. So when it gets to the enzyme, it fuses with the enzyme and it forces the enzyme to change shape. When this happens, the enzyme is activated and it releases, signals for a cellular response. After the response is received, the enzyme here becomes dephosphorylated, and then it reduces phosphate and releases the GDP. Now the GDP and then this G protein right here can be reused again while this remains inactive until another signal is received. This is the tyrosine kinase receptor. The tyrosine kinase receptor receives a signal with a signal by the site. Now this part of the site is outside the cytoplasm, and then this part of it is inside. Then when it receives the signal, it fuses together to form a dimer. Now this dimer here becomes activated through the use of ATP. Then when ATP attaches itself to this, ATP becomes ADP, and then the phosphate binds with the tyrosine protein here to activate the kinase process, and then binds with an enzyme to release signals for the cellular response. Now this is another type of receptor called the iron chemical receptor. This functions as an open gate. Yeah. Okay. When a signal is received, this gate opens and then ions flow through. When the ions flow through, the concentration of that particular ion becomes more in the cytoplasm and then causes the cell to respond to the signal. Yeah. When a signal is not when a signal is not received, the gate closes and then nothing flows through. This is the transduction process. This is where cell translates the signal to understand the language for the cell to understand before a response can take place. Now when a signal is received, a chain of reactions take place. Now second lesson is, second lesson is some type of proteins that act as, that act in the transcription process. They also relay information from the receptors also to the response stage. First messages are obviously the receptors, and then the second messages are small or soluble protein produced by the fused to the cell. Last stage of the cell signaling process is the response. Now we have tropism. Tropism is the growth of organism towards an external stimulus. Tropism does not only occur in plants, it occurs in humans as well. That's the main cause of brain tumor in most people. Oxen is a plant compound that's responsible for elongation of the cell. Yeah, different types of tropism. We have phototropism, which is the broken response to the light. We have chemotropism, which is the response to chemicals. We have geotropism, which is the broken response to gravity. And then somatropism, which is the broken response to cell. And hydrotropism is the broken response to water. Cell signaling is the it's a system of communication in cells where signals received by receptors are translated into an understanding language at the transaction stage, and then the response is received.